Yo, what's good? Welcome back to another episode of Levitation, the Sunday series, where we're coming back with a good one, we're coming back with a great one, we're coming back with a banger. You feel what I'm saying? Hey, listen, I'ma tell you again, like I told you before, go down there, press that subscribe button, and while you're down there, go ahead, leave a like, and while you're down there, leave a comment, and then if you will be so kind, go ahead and share it with those if you find it beneficial and that it can help. I promise you, it will go a long way. Hey, listen, I don't tell you to do these things for nothing. It works the algorithm. That's how the algorithm works. So the more you like it, the more you comment, the more you share, that's the more it shows it to other people. Let's get it. With all that being said, let's hop into it. I hope it bless you. We've all had our experiences with technology. Most of us have iPhones. Some of us have Android. Some of us have MacBook. Some of us have Windows. No matter what you have, right, the technology essentially works the same. And in the technology, there is something called the motherboard. And the motherboard is essentially the brain that makes the technology operate and work. And that is essentially how we are as humans as well, right? Our brains tells us what to do, and it's essentially the motherboard that dictates to our body what to do and when to do it, how to do it, why to do it. That means that our brain, the way that we think, determines how we act. One thing I think that we get wrong in the faith is that we think that once we accept the faith, that accepting the faith is automatically going to change what we do. And that's not what happens. I think when we think that, we're skipping a major step that helps us to be able to live righteously. See, we focus so much on what we can't do and what we can do that we don't think about the reasoning why. And if we read scripture, it's consistently talking about how our minds have to be renewed. Our minds have to be updated. Our minds have to be changed in order for us to live in a way that represents the faith. Just like all technology now, we require an update. And what that means is that our software has to be renewed and changed. And if our software is renewed and changed, that's going to help our hardware run smoothly. So the phone itself is hardware, but there's software or programming that allows the phone to do what it's supposed to do. If the software is off, it don't matter how good or how intact the hardware is, the phone won't work. But if the software is intact and the hardware is all cracked up, you can still use the phone because the software is the thing that makes the phone operate. So that's essentially how we operate. Our bodies has been defiled and contaminated with sin. But the reason why it's been defiled and contaminated with sin is because our software, our minds, have been programmed to operate from a perspective of fulfilling the desires and the pleasures that we may have. Whether that's temptation, whether that's theft, whether that's lying, whether we go on and on and on about what is sinful in the eyesight of God. But the reason why we do those things is because our mindsets are programmed to operate and think that that is the way that we have to operate in order to live this life. So when we accept the faith, we have to go through an update. And Paul tells us in one of my favorite scriptures is in Romans 12:2. It says, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. In the scripture, Paul is telling us that we can't continue to operate from the world standards. The things that you used to think is okay in order to get you to the next level, your mind has to be renewed in order to change that behavior. It used to be okay when you were in the world to lie about your taxes. Oh, it's okay for me to add somebody else's kids on my taxes. But what Paul is telling us in the scripture is that our minds have to be renewed in order to align with the standard of God. Well, if God's standard is to not lie, if God's standard is not to steal, if Jesus himself says, give to Caesar what's due Caesar and give to God what's due God, well, then if we are to operate from that new updated standard, our minds have to be reprogrammed to see that as wrong and operate in a new way. How do we renew our minds? We renew our minds by consuming the things that are of God. What is the one thing that we have access to that gives us the characteristics, that gives us the standard of God? The scriptures. In 2 Timothy 3, starting at verse 16, it says, all scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instructions in righteousness, that the man of God may be complete, thoroughly equipped for every good work. In the NLT version, It says, all scripture is inspired by God and is useful to teach us what is true and to make us realize what is wrong in our lives. It corrects us when we are wrong and teaches us to do what is right. God uses it to prepare and equip his people to do every good work. Essentially, what it's saying is that the programming of God is in the scriptures because it teaches you the ways of God. It teaches you the characters of God. It teaches you the standard of God. It teaches you what is right and what is wrong according to God's standard. Look in verse 17, it says, God uses it to prepare and equip his people to do every good work. In order for you to work the way that we're supposed to work in the faith, we have to be reprogrammed by his scriptures, by his programming. That requires us to transform our minds. That means that we gotta watch what we consume. We can't keep on consuming the things that's gonna keep our minds in the place of the old programming. We can't continue to have the same conversations that we was having when our minds was attached to the old programming. We can't participate in certain music, in certain concerts, in certain activity because our minds are supposed to be operating off of new programming. No wonder why we don't work right. No wonder why we don't live according to the faith. No wonder why we keep on falling. It's because we still trying to operate off the old programming. We haven't allowed for an update to be taking place. So what can we do in order to allow for an update to be taken? Well, what does technology do? In order for an update to happen properly, the technology has to be shut off. Most of us, we don't shut off long enough to allow for the new programming to take resonance in our mind. We still going. We still consuming the same stuff. We still operating and continuing to move forward in how we used to live. When it actually takes for us to shut off and allow for God's programming to take effect, maybe you have to get off social media for a while in order to allow for God's programming to take effect. Maybe you have to cut off certain people for some time in order to allow for God's programming to take full effect. Maybe, just maybe, you have to remove yourself from environments that's not productive to the programming that God is trying to install in you. We have to power ourselves off from the world and go into this new program. Allow it to take residence inside of you and make you a new creation. Transform your mind. Then, when you do go back into those old environments, you have a new programming. So you're not going to be doing the same things that you used to do. You're not going to be having the same conversations that you used to have with these group of friends. You're not going to even have a desire to participate in certain things because your programming is new. And we have to make sure that we remain in this new programming and not revert back to the old software. In Ephesians chapter 4, starting at verse 22, Paul says, throw off your old sinful nature and your former way of life, which is corrupted by lust and deception. Instead, let the Spirit renew your thoughts and attitude. Put on your new nature, created to be like God, truly righteous and holy. It says, throw off your old nature. Throw off the former way that you used to live life and allow the Spirit to renew your thoughts, to change you. And when you're changed, now you have a new nature that was created to be righteous and holy like God. The reason why some of us have accepted the faith and still live like we haven't accepted the faith is because we haven't gotten rid of the old programming and we're still operating from that point of view. And we have not allowed the Spirit to create in us a new mind, creating us a new way of thinking. You have to have the same mind that God has about some of the same things that you used to be okay with. And guess what? That does change you. That does make you something new that you're not used to. But that's the whole process of being a new creation. It's not for you to be like you. It's for you to be like God. And that can only be done through the Spirit, which reprograms your mind. So I think a lot of us believers have been operating from an old software. And the things that God wants us to do require an update. But once you get that update, you realize things are a little bit faster. Things are working a little bit more smoothly. It's time for us believers to accept the update. And once we do that, watch how much God can use us. This is Levitation, where we're reaching our highest potential. Stay blessed.